Let me see.
To explain why we're not just having church. We're not just having church. I know we're not just having church because I just don't go preach. I have been on a sabbatical for about 8 months because the Lord told me to. And because the Lord is my source, He takes care of me. And obedience is better than something. When the Lord called me away with Him, not particularly going anywhere, but just having the power to say, no, I can't come, because the Lord said I can't come. And so when I got this phone call, this is one of the very few places that I have preached in a year. I knew the Lord was saying it because He immediately started speaking to me. You all can do me a favor, put your camera phones down because I don't want your phone to catch something that you missed. All right. I believe that we are standing in a divine moment. I don't know about you, but it feels like a divine moment. It feels like something is going to happen. And we will never be the same again. So He started talking to me. And I'm not a really good preacher. I'm just a good listener. I can hear real good. I mean, I can preach real good, but I can hear. So I'm just going to attempt to just tell you what I heard. Because I don't know about you, but I don't want to speak if God's not speaking. Because there's a whole lot of noise in the body of Christ. A whole lot of people that are able to take the text and work the text. But what causes the text to work is when the Lord has chosen for that moment. That's what He wants to say. And so it's not the art of preaching. It's the art of hearing from God. And so when I started hearing Him, He started talking about the book of Genesis, and I know that's a very familiar scripture about in the beginning. Amplified Bible said, God prepared, formed, fashioned, and created the heavens and the earth. And the book of Genesis, the first chapter, goes on to tell us about what happened. So we tear that chapter out and they take our Bibles, we can know how creation came about. And then when you look at Genesis 1 and 11 and 12, and I believe that's where He wants to take the text from tonight. You'll get your Bibles and go there with me, Genesis 1, 11 and 12. And God said, let the earth put forth tender vegetation, plants, yielding seed and fruit. Trees yielding fruit whose seed is in itself, each according to its kind, upon the earth, and it was so. The earth brought forth vegetation, plants yielding seed according to their own kinds, and trees bearing fruit in which was their seed. took its path. And God saw that, and it was good, suitable, admirable, and he approved it. The part that he keeps ringing in my ears is the part that says, whose seed is in itself. Whose seed is in itself. So then when you move to the second verse, second chapter, the fourth through the seventh verse, it begins to give us the timeline that all of this took place. And the timeline was that God created the heavens. He created the waters, the seas. And then the Lord spoke to the earth. And it said, and the earth came into existence, and it was. Then the Lord said, I'm going to scoop up the dust from the earth, and I'm going to make man. I'm going to do this. From the dust of the earth, he made man. So then he said in Genesis 8 and 22, that because I did this, because I did it this way, because this was the way that I wanted to form this thing called the world. This is the way I wanted to activate what I considered my creation. He said, as long as my creation is in existence, while the earth remains, there will be seed time. Not seed and time, seed time. A connected word. There will be seed time. And harvest. Cold and heat. And summer and winter. And day and night shall not cease. So then that means that somewhere in the world, there's daylight going on. Even though we sit in the dark. And you know what? That's what I love about God. Because even though we're sitting over here in America in the dark, there's sunlight somewhere else. And that right there becomes a revelation about the way the Lord wants us to walk with him. And even though it's nighttime, we can still separate. Because somewhere in the midst of our lives, there's a daylight that is going on that we know nothing about. We may not be able to see it. You know what I'm talking about. We may not be able to see it. That's the reason why I praise God. I don't praise God because I see the light. I praise the Lord because I know there is light. All things are working together for the good to them that love God, to those that are called according to his purpose. So no matter where I am right now, it's working for me. No matter what kind of darkness I'm in right now, it's shedding some light somewhere. So then he says, as long as the earth remains, and I'm here looking at 100 years. I'm looking at 100 years. And so then when you look at the scripture, then you have to ask yourself, seed time, seed time, seed time, seed time, harvest. God made the earth. God made the vegetation. God made the dust of the earth. And all of a sudden, he took this dust. Why did he take this dust and make man? Why did he make man out of a leaf? Why did he make man out of something? Why did he take the dust of the earth and make man? And then you look at this thing and you go, something is happening. This is what I kept saying to the Lord. I said, God, you're trying to say something here. And I don't know what you're trying to say. Because when I look at this, man wasn't born. He was spoken into existence. Man is not the result of genes. He is the result of a word. That's what I know. I know for a fact. I know for myself that that's the reason why I can't live by bread alone. But the only way that I can live is by the word that proceeded out of the mouth of God. And when I can hear the word, I feel pain. See, I don't know about you. I don't know about you. Because the Bible talks in my bones that I'm born of the word. When you are born of the word, that is your God. When you are born of the word, the only way that you can exist is by hearing the word. When you and my father Jesus. I'm the result of the word spoken. I'm the result of the word that was spoken into, watch this, into existence. And why? And why? Because he said that we are born not of a corruptible seed. We are born not of a corruptible seed, but an incorruptible seed. And then the text moves on to tell us this, that when Jesus decided that he was coming, and let me word this one, when God decided, that's what I love about God, because the Spirit of the Lord is always seeking for manifestation. That's why I know that God is going to do something in this place tonight. His greatest manifestation, according to the text, would come into the earth realm, not of the form of an angel, but the form of a seed.
And
the seed, the first part of that scripture said that when the seed fell, the birds came immediately. The bird is, the birds are the satanic spirit that comes to eat the seed as soon as the seed falls, because there's a reason why the devil is afraid of eating the seed. To minister, and a lady brought a fruit basket in the room. She had me fruit basket. She said, "This is for you." And I said, "Thank you so much." And so I was looking at the fruit, and it looked like an apple, and then it looked like a pear. And so I said to the lady, I said, "This looks different." I said, "It's not as colorful as an apple, but it's kind of like a pear." She said, "It's an apple pear." And so I had already bit it, and she said, "It's an apple pear." So I'm chewing, and I said, "What's that?" She said, "Oh, it's when they mix the seeds together." I spit it out. She said, "It's under the room." I said, "Baby, I can eat mixture." Walk in the fruit department, and everything just looks beautiful. And just shining, they got the strength. But then I didn't see that sign. I didn't see that little bitty sign that said GMO. No GMO. And I said, what does that mean, God? And so he helped me to look up GMO. And GMO is genetically modified organism. In other words, they take a piece of the real thing. And they mix it with some chemicals. They mix it with some foreign substances. And watch this. The sad thing about it is when they take a piece of what is real and mix it with something that is false, it looks better than the real thing. I'm not picking it up. It's shiny. It's lustrous. I'm not here. They got pretty tongues in the church now. Let's just show you. They got good, real little cute dances. And everybody not doing praise books. And there ain't no real praise in God. That's you trying to get some points on your Facebook page. And so everything now look more pretty. And look more gorgeous. But the Holy Ghost said it's a GMO salvation. It's meant to literally modify to look like the real thing. To sound like the real thing. But there ain't no power in it. Who am I preaching to? Somebody gonna open a pool now. You gonna open a pool now. Your prayer ain't got no power. It doesn't shift anything.
Yeah.
how we gonna turn it around? Well, I was reading in the book of Daniel. Daniel 9, the fourth chapter. And so, Nebuchadnezzar. You know, I had to tell the Lord one day in my private time, I want you to use me for real. I don't think y'all heard what I just said. I don't want y'all stop preaching. I want you to use me for real. I'm not gonna y'all talk to me. I don't care if they mess it up being famous. I want you to use me for real. I want you to use me to preach the real gospel.
Thank you.
when I count up all of the people that have mentored my life and birthed my life, that I got about 200 years of. And said, and shouted, come. because something has infiltrated itself in us. And now Applebee's is growing bananas. Because something that got in that's been started making it not look like what it looked like 100 years ago. Like, what the hell am I going to do? I don't see the pictures of all the church mothers lined up and this is a travailing church. Listen, the church of the living God is a travailing church. And then this cute mess y'all trying to make. It's the cute of praise and worship. It's the cute of slain and step to the left and step to the left. Oh, skip all that. Because I can just remember this. When he leads me, I will follow. Thank you. traumatic situation, and you don't see nothing, and I'm going to ask you every day to still believe me. God, I can't get nobody to talk to me right now. Hold up, I'm sick to get each other, and I can't don't see it. I'm trying. He said, but maybe he can let me hit up something else, because I'm not going to stop taking you to school until you tell me that you believe me. I'm still trying to figure out, well, what do I have to do to believe you, huh? She would tell you how many pictures I have taken of the manifestations of God, the manifestations of Him. He told me one day, Bishop, he said, come outside. I came outside, and the sky started coming down on me, and I started backing on it, I backed up against the wall. And he said, keep your ears to my lips. And I said, yes, Lord. He said, I said, keep your ears to my lips. I said, yes, Lord. He said, look up, and here come an angel with a big pair of lips. He said, get your phone and take a picture. I took 9 pictures of it. He said, I'm ready. I shall be a performance. See, this thing about the interest that I'm here. Maybe the interest that I'm here because I understand what he means when he says, there shall be a performance. So he said, let's look at this. He said, do you remember when I was walking down the road and I looked up and I saw a fig tree? And I said, he said, read that. He said, I saw a fig tree and I was hungry. Like I am tonight. I'm hungry. I'm hungry for my will, and I don't look over in this church tonight. And I see some fig trees. And he said to me, now I'm going to show you how to believe you. He said, the fig tree, when I walked up on it, I want to know why you ain't got no figs. I want to know, why aren't you preaching in the dimensions I told you to? I want to know, why are you not praying in the realms that I called you to? Why are you giving me hallelujah leads, but you ain't got nothing that feeds me?
He said,
this is my problem. My problem is the fig did not come into existence from another seed. The fig originates back in Genesis. The fig came because I spoke it into existence. Now, what's the difference between the fig is this? The fig that got tied all up with the earth seasons. The fig that got all tied up with winter and summer and spring and fall. He said, no, 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 no. When I woke up on the fig, I'm the word that spoke you into existence. You are just not producing because I'm in front of you. Who am I talking to?
We got some people in the yourself to God, I'm going to show you something that's going to blow your mind. It's going to blow your mind. I'm going to show you something tomorrow night that's going to blow your mind. Forget it. She wins. And that should be the fact. So then he says, we're going to Revelation. Really, woman? And the dragon came against her to destroy her. But God gave the church women. Was waters of falsities, false doctrines, New Age ways. Can we be out of church in 45 minutes? No, we can't. Not that you've been living like the devil for 45 years. I'm not here about talking to me. I can't get nobody to say nothing.
Give God a real prayer. That's the reason why you Let me start over. This is why.
Sounds so much better.
Never.
No.
Of a church.
Is at a minimum level. Because.
And he needs this.
We are seedless sons. Huh? And the devil has done a great job in trying to get us accustomed to seedless things. Seedless living. Seedless habits. He's trying to make us irritated with seeds. How do you feel like building with seeds?
Yes, you do.
Bring me some seedless grapes. If you give me some seedless water, I can eat it fast. So he has made us so accustomed to seedless food that then we require that in preaching. Give me a seedless message.
Shout and give God a praise. The old one, the pastors used to say, let me hear your range. Because this generation is,
You ain't got no range, you ain't got no nutrients here. You get tired too quickly, you ain't got no travail because there's no seeds in you. It's not about giving nobody talk to me. I'm not giving nobody talk to me.
And so because there's no seed in us, then the people of God don't have faith. So now we gotta get con artists to come in and preach so that we can get some money. Because the people, because you don't want no seed, you want a prophecy. Now hear what I'm talking about. Who am I talking about? Well, the real prophet is on your lap. The real prophet runs to your back seat of your car all week long, and you don't pull it out until you come to church on Sunday.
Somebody said, your soul. We don't have an identification. That's foreign to us. Because the first thing you want to know is, if you want me to sow to God, where is my seedless grave? Where is my false prophecy?
Your friends text me when you keep calling.
was alone. Because your car could go down in this place. If you are in the spirit tonight, catch up. I'm speaking to the seeds that are mine. I'm speaking in the earth realm tonight for the trees to begin to allow the water, like the scripture said, that he did not make man. He didn't let it rain. He waited until the water went into the soil. And then he scooped it up. Because when you become a real tree, everything around you is watered. Everybody that you come in contact with have a new desire to want to know God. Every woman in this building, he spoke to me and he said, I'm going to do them like I did when there was no wine at the wedding. If you bring me something that has a season, the process of making wine is lovely. It has to ferment. It has to go through a lot of changes. But when they brought something that had a seed to Jesus, when he put it in his hand, he raced the time. And it went from a seed quick to wine. Now the Holy Ghost said, I'm erasing time in here. Look, what I get the Holy Ghost.
Restore it back to you.
because you gave it in the mindset of ignorance. I'm not hearing y'all. But he said, now the Bible lets us know this. And I want you to hear this. Whatsoever men's treasure is, they also lies as heart. When you bring your heart to me, he said, it's going to be a seed. Your heart is going to be sacked in my hand. Now!
Not It's a divine shield. It's a divine shield. What's $117? Nothing. Don't get this envelope because I'm not talking to you yet. Everybody just take this envelope. It's for $117. That's what he said.
Guess what? I'm not getting money. I'm planting a seed.